Pasanius took position on Uriel's left, with his bolter held at his side, a broken combat blade held in his cybernetic arm.
"Just like old times,"
said Uriel, keeping an eye on the advancing Necrons.
"No," said Pasanius. "It's not. You and I, the Imperium, things are very different now. But one thing is unchanged. You are, and always will be, my oldest and dearest friend."
Pasanius Lysane serves as a veteran sergeant of the Ultramarines during the 41st millennium. The oldest friend of his 4th Company captain, Uriel Ventris, this giant of a man, even for an Astartes, upheld the honor of his chapter through great personal struggle. By far the strongest of the firstborn Space Marines of his chapter, so large is Pasanius' constitution that a bespoke suit derived from Terminator armor plating had to be crafted to befit his stature. His favored weapon of choice, the heavy flamer, facilitating the purge of his enemies, Pasanius stood by the side of Ventris through thick and thin during his first mission as captain of the 4th Company. Upon the tomb world of Pavonis, the 4th Company combated the forces of the Necron Empire, their mission exacerbated with the revelation that a Catan shard lay dormant beneath the surface of the planet. Defeating the Drukhari raiders and forces of the industrial cartel of Casimir de Valtos, Pasanius lost his right arm to the blade of the unleashed Catan shard, the Nightbringer. Outfitted with a bionic replacement following the conclusion of the battle, with time, this mechanical appendage began to transform. Traces of necrodermis lingered within the stump of Pasanius's arm, yet Lysane resolved not to reveal the taint of Xenos corruption to his peers for fear of censure. Following the battle to defend the world of Tarsus Ultra from the invasion of the Tyranids, Pasanius allowed his captain to abandon their company in order to join the Death Watch to infect the Norn Queen in orbit of the world with a deadly virus. Saving Tarsus Ultra from total annihilation, despite their actions, many Ultramarines under Uriel's charge perished, and for their crimes both Ventris and Lysane were sentenced to undertake a death oath. Traveling to the demon world of the Iron Warriors, Medrengard, the exiled Ultramarines harried the forces of Warsmith Honsu in their efforts to destroy the fell heresies of the Demonculaba. Intrigued by the arm of living metal which Pasanius bore, Honsu ordered his savage morticians to amputate this peculiar appendage and stitch it to his own body. Fighting their way from the confines of the fortress of Cullen Ghul, Ventris and Pasanius succeeded in destroying the Demonculaba and Honsu's laboratories and returned to their chapter absolved of sin. Required to undertake 100 years of penance for failing to bring his affliction to the attention of his peers, Pasanius bid Uriel farewell as the reinstated captain of the Defenders of Ultramar returned to Pavonis once more. Fighting by his friend's side following his atonement, the giant's newly attached bionic arm, forged by the tech marine dreadnought Harkus, proved a fitting replacement. Etching markings into its construction, much to the chagrin of Harkus, Pasanius remains vigilant for signs of Xenos infection by virtue of the necrodermis's proclivity to regenerate living metal. No longer the largest of his chapter, by virtue of several Astartes including Ventris crossing the Rubicon Primaris, despite his firstborn status, Pasanius now dons a modified suit of Mark 10 Tacticus armor. Uriel's return to his company following his transformation into a Primaris Space Marine, showing signs of his detachment to humanity, Pasanius remains hesitant to undergo the procedure himself. For in his heart, Pasanius Lysane fights to preserve the innocence of the Imperium, and the prospect of growing stronger at the price of his compassion is a cost he is unwilling to pay.